Hello guys, welcome to another episode of What Went Wrong. Few weeks ago, I told you people that we are going to be looking at certain prophecies that was released during the Nigeria presidential election in 2023 and try to look at them and share opinion to understand what actually went wrong and why the prophecies that the men of God gave did not come to pass. And in this episode, we are going to be looking at this powerful prophecy from this man of God. He said some things in the prophecies and it has prompted some people and even me to be asking this question: if what he said happened, is the reason why Peter Obi lost the election in 2023. I'm not going to waste your time. I'll just allow you watch this video and then please share your opinion. Let this be an interactive session. Let us share opinion in the comment section. Do you think that what the man of God have said is the reason why Peter Obi lost the election? Watch the video and share your thoughts in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, turn on your notification bell so whenever I post another video, you'll be notified. If you're a returning subscriber, I want to say thank you to you. Thank you for always stopping by to watch our video. And don't forget, share the video and also share the platform, share with your friends and loved ones so people can also join the conversation and also enjoy the video. God bless you as you do so. Watch the video.
And on next Saturday is the Nigeria presidential election.
Uchaguzi wa raisi kule Nigeria.
I have a few words God gave to me.
Ina maneno machache ambayo Mungu amenipa.
That the election,
kwamba uchaguzi,
is a period for Nigeria to choose between light and darkness.
Kipindi cha Nigeria kuchagua kati ya giza na nuru.
This election is between the poor and the rich.
Uchaguzi ni kati ya maskini na tajiri.
And God have given them,
na Mungu amewapa,
a significant option.
Chaguo la muhimu.
But the enemy have,
lakini adui,
set a trap.
Ametega mtego.
Because of the economic crisis.
Kwa sababu ya janga la kiuchumi.
And the devil is using and we use that as an advantage.
Na shetani atatumia hiyo kwa faida yake.
During the currency swap.
Kwenye kubadilisha kwa fedha.
Because of the currency swap that is.
Sababu ya kubadilisha kwa fedha ambapo.
Sponsoring hardship in Nigeria.
Kuna dhamini ugumu kule Nigeria.
A lot will sell their vote.
Wengi watauza kura zao
for money.
Kwa ajili ya pesa.
And they will not elect the one God.
Na watamchagua yule ambaye Mungu
for them.
Amemchagua kwa ajili yao.
And the one God have chosen.
Na yule ambaye Mungu amemchagua
has never contested for president.
Hajawahi kushindania kwa rais, kugombea urais.
But because.
Lakini kwa sababu
of,
yeah,
the wickedness,
uovu.
I see the party in power will not change.
Naona kwamba kile chama ambacho kiko madarakani hakitabadilika.
But the one God have anointed,
lakini yule ambaye Mungu amemtia mafuta,
for the people to choose,
ili watu wamchague,
will be manipulated,
atarubuniwa.
But I'm here to pray,
lakini niko hapa kuomba,
that the political climate will change.
Kwa ile hali ya hewa ya kisiasa ibadilike.
In Nigeria.
Kule Nigeria.
To fall and follow.
Ili ifuate na kuangukia.
The God's plans and purpose for Nigeria.
Kwenye mipango na kusudi la Mungu kwa ajili ya Nigeria.
That the one God have anointed.
Kwa yule ambaye Mungu amemtia mafuta.
And have never contested for president.
Ambaye hajawahi kugombea urais.
We win.
Atashinda.
In the name of Jesus.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Because what I see.
Kwa sababu ninachokiona,
you see, money is being induced.
Naona pesa inaachiliwa
for people,
kwa ajili ya watu,
to elect,
waweze kuchagua
the same old people,
kuchagua wale watu wale wale walokuwepo,
the same party,
chama kile kile.
That is what I see.
Ndio ninachokiona.
But something will happen after the election.
Lakini kitu kitatokea baada ya uchaguzi.
Something will happen.
Kitu kitatokea.
Another thing the Lord says I should pray against is bloodshed.
Kitu kingine ambacho Bwana amesema niombe kinyume chake ni umwagaji wa damu.
Because after the election.
Sababu baada ya uchaguzi.
The party in power will not change.
Kile chama kichopo madarakani hakitabadilika.
After the election.
Lakini baada ya uchaguzi.
The is going to shift some things.
Bwana ataenda kuhamisha baadhi ya vitu.
And the one he anointed will come.
Na yule aliyemtia mafuta atakuja.
And so shall it be.
Na ndivyo itakavyokuwa.
You know, it's a warfare.
Najua ni vita.
Anything can happen.
Chochote kile kinaweza kutokea.
But nothing will stop.
Lakini hakuna kitakachozuia.
The plans of God.
Mipango ya Mungu.
But the dicey part is that.
Lakini sehemu ambayo ina utata.
The ball is at the court of Nigerians.
Ni kwamba mpira uko kwenye mikono ya Nigeria.
Their vote.
Kura zao.
Their vote.
Kura zao.
We pray for free and fair election.
Tunaombea uchaguzi wa huru na haki.
Free, fair.
Uchaguzi wa huru na haki.
And peaceful election.
Na amani.
We pray for Nigeria.
Tunaombea Nigeria.
Let there be peaceful election.
Acha kwenda uchaguzi wa amani.
Let there be no bloodshed.
Usiwe na umwagaji wa damu.
In the name of Jesus.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
The rigging plan, we abort it.
Ile mipango miovu tunaiporomosha.
In Jesus name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Clap for Jesus.
I'm sure you have all heard everything the man of God have said. I'm sure you're listening to everything he said. He said that during the currency swap, that is where a lot of things went wrong, that a lot of people are going to sell their vote and all the rest. So the question now is, could this be the reason why Peter Obi lost the election in 2023? Please, like I said earlier, let us just share opinion. What do you think went wrong here? What do you think went wrong with this prophecy with the 2023 presidential election? Do you think what the man of God have said played a role in causing Peter Obi to lose the election? Share your opinion in the comment section. But another thing I want us to do, another thing I will ask us to do, is that we should do well to pray for our country, Nigeria. I always ask us to pray for Nigeria, not because of anything. It is because I want a better Nigeria. I want a Nigeria that you and I can enjoy. I want a Nigeria where we will all live peacefully and happily. In as much as a lot of us, we want Nigeria to divide, we want Nigeria like we want to go our separate ways, but right now we are still Nigerian. So I want to urge us to do well to pray for our country, Nigeria. Everything I know is going to be well. Things may not be working out right now. Things may not be going very well right now. But I trust that everything is going to work well very soon. But the one thing we can do, the one role we can play as citizens of Nigeria, is that we have to pray. Let us put aside our political affiliations, our religion, and every other thing, our tribe, and pray for our country, Nigeria. Please share your opinion about what the man of God has said concerning 2023 presidential election and why Peter Obi lost the election. He mentioned so many things that people are going to sell their vote and all the rest, that the election is between the poor and the rich. Do you think this was the case? Because I've heard a lot of people say that it is not true, that it is because of what do they call it, that it was INEC that rigged the election. A lot of people on Facebook have been saying that. So let us also start our own interaction here on YouTube. Facebook people are already sharing their opinion, so let me also get your own opinion. The series we are dealing with is What Went Wrong. The idea is just for us to look at these prophecies and try to understand what went wrong and what made the prophecies that the pastors have given not to come out, not to play out the way they have said it. Let's talk about it and let's share opinions. Drop your comment in the comment section. Please don't forget, pray for our country Nigeria. Pray for our country Nigeria. Yes, things are stabilizing a little bit right now. Dollar is going down and down and down. That is what we want. But still, prices of fuel. I was doing some calculation with somebody just yesterday. I was telling the person, had it been fuel is still at 200 or 250. A lot of people will not be complaining too much. But I don't understand why, for a country like Nigeria, an oil producing nation, fuel is at 600 naira plus. It doesn't make sense. The government have to do whatever they can to bring it down, because some of us want to relocate to Nigeria. We want to relocate, but the prices of things is really chasing us away. Because I don't understand why you will be in a country. If Nigeria, okay, if had it been we have steady electricity now, I was okay. But this one, you cannot be outside and you are used to steady electricity and you are coming back to Nigeria to come and banter with NEPA. Every time they are taking the light, it doesn't make sense. So please, let us pray for things to be stabilized. As the dollar is dropping, let every other thing be dropping, especially the fuel. Even though I don't understand why dollar is affecting fuel, I don't think it is what is affecting it. The government have to look into all these things and try to fix it. But they let us just do our own part by praying. Prayer is an important key. I always say that there is always a way we can win this battle that we are trying to fight, the battle for a better Nigeria, the battle for a more united Nigeria, the battle for a great Nigeria. There is a way we can win it without fighting. There is a way we can win it, and prayer is one of those ways. Prayer is an important weapon. It's an important shield we need to go into this battle. I'm telling you that if we go on our knees, pray to God very well, and intercede for our country, Nigeria, a whole lot is going to change. Let us forget about, oh, we hate the president, we don't hate the president, this and that has happened, that has not happened. Let us put all that aside and try to look at how we can do things to make our country better. Because complaining, from what I have known so far, complaining is not going to help us. Crying is not going to help us. Fighting is not going to help us. Doing protests is not going to help us. But prayer, God can actually intervene, because the Bible made us understand the heart, that the heart of kings are in the hands of God, that he can turn it whichever way he wants. I'm telling you that God can actually intervene and touch the heart of Tinubu and our politicians and make them to be doing things right. Also, we have heard prophecies of a prophet and pastor saying that a Cyrus is coming that is going to help deliver Nigeria and reposition Nigeria. Let us pray for that Cyrus to come, because we are tired of what is happening in the country at the moment. A lot of people are crying. A lot of people are going through a lot. Please do well to pray for the country Nigeria. And as you pray for the country Nigeria, God is also going to meet you at the point of your needs in the name of Jesus. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please do well to subscribe to the channel. Turn on your notification bell so whenever I post another video, you'll be notified. If you're a returning subscriber, I want to say thank you to you. Thank you for always stopping by to watch our video. We appreciate the support you have been giving us on this channel. God bless you. God reward you as you have been supporting us. Please don't forget, share the video on all social media platforms. Share with your friends and loved ones so they will know what is happening in our country, Nigeria. God bless you as you do so. I'll see you in the next one. You are blessed.